ladies and limited gentlemen. Thank you very much for the kind invitation. These words I should say only to Dr. Zadeh and his amazing team here in Los Angeles in USC. How is it possible to use lasers in the afternoon here today in the periodontal therapy? And especially, I put in after this invitation an additional here sentence or a question: what are the goals and what we can achieve using lasers in periodontal therapy? Believe or not, this topic is a topic of experience for over 10 years, working with lasers with all of the different wavelengths existing in the international market at the present moment, because some of them, they are not FDA approved. But I decided, for good or not, today to bring you in a level which is a level, if you want, for periodontists and specialists. And I say that because I know this is the Dental Hygiene Symposium, but we have the competition, in a good way competition, that some of you, maybe they are your dentists. Do you agree with me? Thank you. So I don't want really to bring you to a level like a physicist, because I didn't study physics, but I would like to make the main, most important information to bring you from physics, which are important for you and for your office, when you treat patients or you assist to the periodontist or to the general practitioner, maybe, you know, when you do periodontal therapy, okay? So I try really to focus on the different wavelengths and especially to focus in the first question here: what is the correct laser wavelength for your clinical practice? If I go and I give you right now the answer, nobody of these beautiful women will stay in this room. But I didn't come here from Rochester, New York, to teach you which laser machine is important for you. And honestly, I don't care, because I'm a professor and I'm not a person who works with companies. Do you understand? You have to understand the physics. It's the same thing in periodontal therapy. Sometimes we use the Kirkland, the Orban knife, periodontal knife, and sometimes we use the curette, and sometimes we use the scaler. And every instrument has a special indication. But the main difference here is if you use a special machine from these machines, for example, in order to remove hard tissue, calculus, maybe one of these units does not work and another unit works. And that's why we have to find out what kind of goals we have in periodontal therapy.